This video was created by librarians at Southern Utah University. It is the third in a series on synthesizing information. In this video, we learn how to use an information synthesis matrix once it has been completed. In spite of the matrix being a relatively simple grid, it is a powerful instrument in research-based writing. As a diagnostic tool, it can tell you whether you need to do more research or if you have enough in the matrix to write a good paper. Let's look at this example to understand both the diagnostic power and the writing support a matrix can provide. First, the diagnostic power. Once you have your matrix populated with multiple sources and ideas, you can see how your research stands. When a row with an idea has only one source that discusses that particular idea, you will know that you need to do some additional research. For good synthesis, you need at least two sources because each main idea needs other sources to support it. You can either do a targeted search for more sources about that specific idea, or if this idea is peripheral, not that important to your paper, you can leave it out. Conversely, if your row has a lot of information in it and is almost too dense to fit into a short summary, you might have two ideas. In this case, you can split a row into two or more rows for each subtopic. Finally, when a column has a source that only has a single idea in the matrix, it can mean one of two things. One, that source might not be a good fit for the paper you are writing since it doesn't capture multiple ideas in the conversation. It can also mean that you simply did not spend enough time with the source and you are missing other ideas. It is rare that a source only discusses a single idea. You can keep the source if it makes an important point for your paper, or you can replace it with a source that is more relevant to the work you are doing. Now let's look at the writing power of the matrix. Writing is difficult, especially getting started. It is often helpful to start with an outline and then flesh it out. The first column of the matrix contains all the ideas you pulled out of your sources. This is your universe of ideas. You can take them all and put them in a logical order. During this process, you can decide to drop certain ideas when they are too far outside your topic. Once you have an outline that flows well, it's time to start writing your draft paragraphs. Each row represents an idea that can become a section or paragraph of your paper. For example, you can write your first draft of a paragraph or section on video games as a form of play using the text in the cells. You do not have to go back to the original source, and since the text is now in your own words, you don't have to worry about accidentally plagiarizing your sources. All the sources with text in that row will be what you cite in that section to write that synthesized paragraph. You can use the in-text citations at the top of each row for this row, since you already created your in-text citations. Combining the author names with the page numbers in each cell, you can create an MLA in-text citation. Let's go back to our matrix example from the first video. The research topic the matrix was created for is the impact of positive reinforcement on dog behavior. We are including the rest of the matrix in the following slides. Based on the ideas collected in the first column of the example matrix in the previous slides, the outline for this paper on the impact of positive reinforcement on dog behavior could be as follows. Start with an introduction, maybe then talk about history of dog training, what is positive dog training, human-animal bond or love, the use of treats and play, what is key for a dog to learn, and then, of course, the conclusion. To write the draft paragraph, start by building the paper outline. The draft paragraphs will look something like this. First, introduce the idea. Use your supporting, contradicting, or qualifying information. Add your own voice and provide your own interpretation. And then make connections between information on ideas by using transition words. Transition words help you, the writer, guide your reader through the scholarly conversation on your topic. They help you make connections between ideas. There are many more transition words than the ones we've listed here, but this will give you some idea of what we mean. So here's a draft paragraph for the idea of positive dog training from the matrix on the impact of positive reinforcement on dog behavior. Notice how each source is discussed and properly cited to create our narrative. You are now ready to start capturing the ideas from your source and store them in a synthesis matrix. Use the matrix to diagnose where your research stands and whether you need to find additional information. Once your matrix is complete, you can use it to outline your paper and start writing. Happy synthesizing!